With the pending arrival of Denis Villeneuve's highly anticipated adaptation of the first part of Frank Herbert's Dune, I've been exploring the lore behind the various characters and elements that make up this epic story. One of the characters that plays a large role in the Dune saga that we very well might be able to get a glimpse of in Villeneuve's first film is Aaliyah Atreides, who also came to be known later as Saint Aaliyah of the Knife. In this video, I'd like to talk about the extraordinary circumstances that influenced and altered who Aaliyah is, and what we might get to see of this character in Villeneuve's first Dune film. Beware that there will be spoilers in this video, as many of the events that influence this character don't happen until midway through Frank Herbert's book. Keep in mind that this video will only cover events involving her character in this first film, but I'll be sure to continue covering her journey through Frank Herbert's series in future videos. Aaliyah Atreides is the daughter of Duke Leto Atreides and his Bene Gesserit concubine, Lady Jessica. Very early on, due to her Bene Gesserit training and supreme awareness of her body, Jessica became aware of her pregnancy with Aaliyah, but didn't reveal the fact to Leto before his death. After House Harkonnen's attack on House Atreides, who had recently taken over stewardship of Arrakis, Jessica and Paul are able to escape from the clutches of the Harkonnens. They are forced to flee into the open desert. It is here that Paul reveals to Jessica that through his prescience, he is aware of his mother's pregnancy with Aaliyah, which serves as evidence that he is in fact the Bene Gesserit's Kwisatz Haderach, the super being they've been working for generations to produce. As Jessica and Paul journey through the desert, they eventually come across a Fremen siege. The Fremen's culture had been heavily imprinted by the religious engineering performed thousands of years earlier by the branch of the Bene Gesserit referred to as the Missionaria Protectiva. For more information on the Missionaria Protectiva, be sure to check out my video on the subject where I dive deeper into the black arm of the Sisterhood and the inner workings of their mission. Because of this imprinting that had been performed by the Missionaria Protectiva, the Fremen had many religious customs that were very similar to the Bene Gesserit, even using many of the same terms. One of the more notable similarities was that their spiritual leaders are women who are also referred to as Reverend Mothers, and they even shared some of the same rituals. The Fremen were encouraged by Jessica's arrival for a couple of reasons. First, their own Reverend Mother Romala was old and near death. Jessica was the perfect choice to replace her, given that she would be able to have Romalo's training. Secondly, prophecies of the coming of the Fremen Messiah were foretold many eons earlier, including the detail that he was to be born of a Bene Gesserit. Paul and Jessica make use of these prophecies and the suspicions of the Fremen people in order to ensure their protection and survival. These are the extraordinary circumstances that brought about the event that would irreversibly affect and fundamentally transform Jessica's daughter, Aaliyah. This event was called the Spice Agony, a ritual Jessica had to undergo to become the Fremen's next Reverend Mother. The Fremen Spice Agony mirrored the Bene Gesserit ritual of the same name. In the Bene Gesserit version, an acolyte of the Sisterhood would ingest a poison awareness spectrum narcotic called the Water of Life, which was the liquid exhalation of a sandworm produced at the moment of its death by drowning in regular water. After ingesting this poison, a potential Reverend Mother would have to change the substance within themselves to neutralize its toxicity. Each Bene Gesserit member was trained in the mastery of internal organic chemical control. After successfully undergoing the physical and mental trauma caused by the Spice Agony ritual, a Reverend Mother accesses what is known as other memory, gaining the memories and personalities of all her female ancestors, resulting in an immense and sudden accumulation of knowledge and power. It is thought that only those with strict mental discipline and Bene Gesserit training would be able to prevent these ancestral egos and memories from taking over their consciousness. Because Lady Jessica was pregnant at the time of undergoing the Spice Agony, the fetus of Aaliyah was also exposed to this accumulation of memories and personas. In a sense, she was pre-born, awakened within the womb as a Reverend Mother. This means that Aaliyah would essentially be a grown woman in a child's body, and a full Reverend Mother from birth. However, she did not have the ability to prevent her consciousness from being overcome by the memories of her ancestors, and without having formed her own distinct personality, these ego memories fundamentally formed her psyche. Having undergone the Spice Agony at this phase in her life, she was predestined for psychological instability, becoming what the Bene Gesserit referred to as abomination. Those who were deemed abomination were feared and were considered very dangerous by the sisterhood. As such, the Bene Gesserit had standing orders to immediately kill anyone believed to be abomination. However, this deep into the desert of Arrakis, the other members of the Bene Gesserit sisterhood were nowhere to be found, and thus Aaliyah was allowed to live. It's thought that Villeneuve's first film will end at the 2-year time jump found about 2/3 of the way through Herbert's first book. That being said, what we can expect to see from Aaliyah in this film would most likely all take place during Jessica's spice agony, which occurs before this time jump. During this scene, the old Reverend Mother of the Fremen tribe communes with Jessica, transferring all of her knowledge and memories to her. Jessica thinks of this as a hallucination, as the book describes it. It was like an ultimate simpatico, being two people at once, not telepathy, but mutual awareness. During the ritual, as the Reverend Mother is speaking to Jessica, she pauses and then realizes that Jessica is with child, and then exclaims, "You should have told us you are pregnant. This changes both of you." This is when Jessica senses Aaliyah's presence in the ritual. Herbert describes it as a forced shift in the mutual awareness, as she sees another mote presence with the inward eye, one which was darting wildly here and there, circulating and radiating pure terror. She's then instructed by the old Reverend Mother to reach out gently to touch her daughter's presence, to soothe and absorb the fear, which Jessica is able to do by radiating love, comfort, and protection until Aaliyah's terror recedes. This scene will certainly be a sight to behold in Villeneuve's film. I'm especially interested to see how he handles it given his remarkable track record of creating stunning visuals. In the previous adaptations, this scene has been very trippy to say the least. I personally much prefer the sci-fi miniseries depiction over the 1984 version. While I certainly admire Lynch's courage in presenting such a bold visual style in his adaptation, there are many times in that movie that are hard for me to stomach, and the spice agony scene in which Aaliyah is pre-born is certainly one of them. In the sci-fi miniseries, we still see the fetus of Aaliyah, but it's much easier to look at. The rest of the visuals for the scene are quite impressive given the lower budget they were working with. During this ritual in the book, Jessica is seeing with the inward eye. When she comprehends the old Reverend Mother, she is described as a young girl with a dancing spirit and tender humor. However, when she becomes aware of Aaliyah's presence, she's only described as a mote or particle which darted wildly here and there. There are many ways to interpret this, so it will be interesting to see how this plays out in Villeneuve's film, but I personally wouldn't mind seeing an artistic representation over a physical one. We don't really see anything else from Aaliyah until the third section of Herbert's Dune novel, so I don't expect that an actress will be cast for this part until we get closer to the production of the second part of Villeneuve's adaptation. That being said, Paul does see Aaliyah in his prescient visions, so it could be possible that they've already cast her for these visions, and that we'll get to see her in the film. Ultimately, it is these events which irreversibly mold and form who Aaliyah is. The resulting instability and bizarre nature of her character are prevalent in the pivotal events that unfold later in the book. But I'm curious to know what you think of the spice agony scene and how you think Villeneuve should depict it in his film. What's your opinion on the previous attempts to adapt this scene? Are there any elements from previous versions you'd like to see incorporated into Villeneuve's film? Let me know in the comments section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Dune and other sci-fi and fantasy content. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.